This week's lab is on the energy of a peanut. We're going to explore thermochemistry, the energy of chemical reactions, and this week we're going to see if we can figure out how much energy is contained within a peanut, and in order to do that, we're going to burn the peanut and then measure the amount of melt that's produced. Ice in our can here set up on the bench. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to go grab a peanut and go into the balance room and take the mass of the peanut, the initial mass. Then we're going to come back out here and we're going to take that peanut and we're going to wrap it up in our special holder so that we can light it. And hold it under our calorimeter. We're going to put some ice in the calorimeter. And then we're going to light our peanut. Sometimes this is the hardest part, to try and get that peanut to burn very well. And when we get it going good, we're going to hold it underneath our calorimeter. And the flame of the burning peanut, of course, is going to be melting the ice. I'm going to just hold it there as the peanut burns. The ice is melting, and then obviously at some point the peanut will go out. I'm going to skip that step. And then you're going to take the peanut back in and mass it again to get the final mass. And from that, you're going to subtract the initial mass. From the final mass, from the initial mass, to get the burned mass of the peanut that is melting the ice. You're then going to take your graduated cylinder, and all I have is a beaker here, and you're going to measure out the amount of melt water produced. This is a beaker, and I shouldn't be using a beaker, I should be using a graduated cylinder, but you get the general idea. I didn't produce much melt because I didn't wait long enough. And then we're going to use that melt then as a way of quantifying the energy in the peanut. You may recall that water has an enthalpy of fusion of about 80 calories per gram, and so we'll be able to figure out the energy contained within the peanut. And like all good experiments, then you're going to replicate it by doing it twice, and then on the back of the lab, we sort of walk you through those energy calculations. So have fun with it. Oh, P.S., if you're allergic to peanuts, please let us know before we start this experiment.